Distrohopping is one of the most ridiculous and fascinating phenomena in the beautiful history of Linux. It's ridiculous because one of the main drivers of distrohopping is dissatisfaction. People find themselves upset about their distros of choice while keeping the belief that they could do better. They just need to install another Linux distro. But it's also fascinating because there is something inside us that fuels our enthusiasm, something that makes us patient and open-minded. There are a lot of people in Linux community who genuinely believe that distrohopping in itself, as a phenomenon, is rather bad, and for a good reason. To some of them, it looks like a way of running from problems. They are righteously annoyed by the fact that people will happily prefer to jump from one distribution to another just because it promises flawless experience right out of the box, even if it might become dormant or discontinued in a few years. But what if I tell you that never-ending process of installing new distros can be good for you? Let's be honest, daily driving advanced Linux distros like Debian, Arch or Gentoo requires some dedication, knowledge and skill. So for those who yet suffers from lack of knowledge or skill, but has a proper amount of dedication, distrohopping can become a joyful form of practicing. More than that, the process of distrohopping can help newcomers to understand the nature of an operating system. Operating system of any kind is not a some sort of indivisible thing, no, it has components. And distrohopping enables beginners to test those components on a very practical level. It helps you to deconstruct an entire OS into building blocks and kind of experience every each of them separately. It's easy to spot a difference between two distinct package managers, or two different underlying philosophies, while distrohopping between distros that share the same desktop environment. The best way to learn how to install and use Linux is to install all kinds of Linux distributions and use them for an extensive period of time. You'd probably would like to start with those that promises flawless experience out of the box, right? White monospace font on a black screen seems pretty scary right now. And no wonder that our human brain is trying its best to keep ourselves away from it by turning on battery saving mode and automatically suspending all new information. The abundance of user-friendly distributions creates undesirable incentives for the newcomers. You see, some people have a tendency to wave away from an advanced distribution as soon as they face an obstacle that possibly could be resolved with a couple of shell commands. And because there are plenty of user-friendly distributions designed to work out of the box, optimized for gaming or tailored for creative professionals, it may feel like it doesn't worth the hassle to invest your time into actual process of learning. But of course, what comes around goes around. Sooner or later, after a few successful attempts at distrohopping, our brain will embrace new and interesting activity by rewarding ourselves with a dopamine release. Please be careful, because from this moment you are in danger of installing all kinds of advanced and unfamiliar looking distributions just to squeeze out a little more of that fancy chemical and to prove yourself that you are capable of doing something challenging. I'm not saying that you should spend your time installing all kinds of obscure Linux distros, no. But in order to become an open-minded and skillful person, you have to resist all kinds of rational fears and force yourself into trying something new or even going back to something old but gold. Oh, and by the way, what was your first Linux distro? Maybe you've got one of those Ubuntu CDs back in the day. Maybe your Linux journey began with the first public release of SteamOS. Or you've decided to learn Linux in order to open a new career path for yourself. No matter what, I encourage you to find an old ISO and install it today on a virtual machine or an old laptop. I promise you'll get an insane amount of joy by comparing contemporary Linux distros to their predecessors. But at the same time, there is something magical about trying new and unfamiliar distros for the first time. I really like how casually it was described by Liam Dore, the owner of GamingOnLinux.com, who, few years ago, in one of his articles wrote that he felt a bit stuck, Ubuntu was too safe, not particularly exciting, and he didn't want another normal distro. Incredible! You see, this is what I'm talking about, this is the poetry of distro hopping. It is difficult to explain this way of thinking to somebody who prefers to use macOS as a daily driver. even in case of Windows. Since Windows 7 isn't officially supported anymore, you have to choose between Windows 10 and Windows 11, and there is not much of a difference between them in terms of user experience. The pursuit of joy in switching from Windows 10 to 11 is futile. But if you decide to install Arch after years of daily driving Mint or PopOS, you'll notice a significant difference in terms of user experience, even if you would pick the same desktop environment that you are already familiar with. But when you get into thinking that a certain OS is too normal for you or too safe, you know, it says a lot about you, how you treat your personal computer, how you associate your lifestyle with tech surrounding you, and that is awesome! It's also worth mentioning that distrohopping, while being nothing but a hobby for those of us who have a lot of spare time, plays a huge role in the evolution of Linux for desktops, since it is the only way for us to try some new and fancy stuff. Yes, some distros eventually might become dormant or discontinued, but it's all about trying something new. You see, every one of us is different. We share common goals as a community, but we all have different preferences. And so I guess every one of us is doomed to waste a small amount of time on distro hopping in case if we want to find that special flavor of Linux that works best for us. And last but not least, the very act of installing a new distro, I believe, can remind you about something you fell in love years ago. Linux is Linux. Whether you install an OpenSUSE or Debian or Gentoo, you are still going to experience the same level of freedom. The truth is, you don't need to jump from one system to another. You can just stick with a distro that works best for you. But the fact that you don't need to doesn't mean you won't, right? Huh, me too. This was Reluctant Anarchist, and I have nothing left to say.